Dr. Reed, you're needed in the OR, stat. We have a patient that is in desperate need of surgery, but everyone has forgotten most of their anatomical terms.
Really?
Yes, this patient needs an incision starting from their left acromial region to their right tarsal. Please help.
I taught my interns about a few body parts and regions in my Cardi B remix, but it appears that they need a bit more help. And maybe you do too. In the description box, there's a link to the commonly used anatomical terms that I teach in my class. You should definitely have this in front of you. Let's get started. As this patient's surgeon, the first thing I have to keep in mind is that my right is the patient's left, and my left is the patient's right. My colleague told me that I need to start my incision on the patient's left acromial region. I remember that the acromial is the shoulder because acrobats stand on each other's shoulders for certain stunts. Okay, so the incision has started. Now I need to get to the middle of the body. There are two terms that you need to know, lateral and medial. Lateral means side and medial means middle. Since I'm trying to make an incision to the middle of the body, I will cut medially to the midline of the body. If I started at the midline of the body and wanted to make a cut to the left acromial region, I will cut laterally to the left acromial region because I'm going to the side. Let's test your knowledge of lateral and medial with two body parts. The orbital area is to the nasal area. If you said lateral, that's right, because your eyes are on either side of your nose. Your nose would be medial to your eyes because it's in the middle. All right, let's get back to the patient. We are trying to reach the right tarsal, which is the ankle, so we need to move our incision south. That brings us to our next two terms, superior and inferior. Superior or cranial means towards the head, and inferior or caudal means away from the head. Since I'm trying to make an incision towards the ankle and away from the head, I will cut in the inferior direction or caudally until I reach the pelvic region. We are halfway there. Remember, I started my incision on the left acromial region and I'm ending my incision on the right tarsal. Right now, I'm in the middle of the pelvic region, and I need to make my incision towards the hip or coxal area. Should I cut laterally to the left coxal area, or should I cut laterally to the right coxal area? If you said cut laterally to the right, you are correct.
Dr. Reed, you don't have much longer. You need to wrap this up.
Okay, so now we need to move south again to reach the tarsal, but here's the biggest mistake my interns make. Since we are now moving down the leg, which is an appendage, your arms are appendages too, we will now use the terms proximal and distal. Proximal means closer to the torso, and distal means further away from the torso. Since the tarsal is further away from your torso, we will cut distally along the femoral area, which is your thigh.
But Dr. Reed, posterior femoral area?
That's a great question. Anterior or ventral means front, and posterior or dorsal means back. So we are cutting distally along the anterior femoral area. Almost there. The lower part of your leg between your patella, which is the front part of your knee, and your tarsal is called the crural area. So we will continue cutting distally along the anterior crural region until we finally reach the tarsal. Well, it looks like our patient is gonna be okay. All right, guys, come on over. Let's stitch them up. And while they're doing that, let's see what you remember.
The popliteal area is to the patellar area. If you said posterior or dorsal, you are correct. The popliteal area is behind the patellar area. Remember, you gotta pat and pop. The digits are to the carpals. If you said distal, you are correct. Remember, we use the words distal or proximal when referring to body parts on the same appendage. Last one. This one may be tricky, but if you use the handout that's in the description box, I know you can do it. The muscle is to the skin. If you said deep, you are correct. When a guy likes a girl solely based on how they look, you would call him superficial, meaning that he likes just what he sees on the surface. So since the skin is toward the surface of the body, we would say the skin is superficial to the muscle. And since muscle is away from the body's surface, we say the muscle is deep to the skin.
Wow, we learned a lot. You learned 12 body regions and 10 directional terms. I hope that helped, and I'll see you in the next one. Science G, signing out.
Code blue. Code blue.